Next, we have again the gradient wash, but this time we are using the wet on wet technique. The process is almost same. Only the difference is we just have to apply water on the paper before putting the color. Let's apply the fresh water on the paper. And this time I am using two colors in the gradient. First is the sap green and another one is chrome yellow. So I want to give like the top part, the dark part with the sap green, and the down tone will be the chrome yellow. The process will be exactly the same what we did for the wet and dry technique. Here we will feel the flow of brush or the flow of colors will be more smooth as compared to the wet and dry, because paper is also wet and the color is also wet. They merge really nice into each other and give us a very good flow to work with. Here also you can do the multiple layering depending on how much dark or how much light gradient you need. So for the lighter part, just take water, don't take color, and spread it out. To make the top part darker, you can just take a little bit more color to make it more prominent. For the smooth merging, just take water and spread it evenly with the brush all over the work. Here we have our gradient base ready by using the wet on wet watercolor technique.